Okay, they say it gets better when you start, okay? So nervous. Okay, hi everyone, my name is Sandra Andre. The title of my project is Luminange of Francophone Culture and William Wells Brown's Hotel. I will begin my presentation with a quotation from William Wells Brown's Hotel that inspired me to look into what I call Luminange. Clotel now urged Horatio to remove to France or England, where both her and her child will be free and where color was not a crime. In the English language, le mélange can be translated from the French language to mix. I took this word wondering about the different mix that the author was using to create his novel. It was not only the mixture of identity or characters, or the mixture of American culture during slavery that attracted me to this project. It was also about the mixture of another culture, a culture that demonstrated hope and freedom to Black American slaves, the Francophone culture. This thought that Brown put forth in his novel helped me develop my research question. What connection did William Wells Brown have with Francophone culture, France, Haiti, New Orleans, and Canada, and how does this connection influence the novel Clotel? First and foremost, to understand the connection that the author had with the culture, I had to research deeply into the French history and its colonial history concerning freedom and slavery. I soon came to find out a few important facts that would connect Brown to the Francophone culture. An important discovery was that France was the first colonizer to abolish slavery, a theme which is essential in the novel. Slavery was abolished in 1794, 5 years after the French Revolution. This was an important step into what Brown referred to as an incubus that hung over the southern states. What was very astonishing was in 1802, Napoleon Bonaparte reinstated slavery. I researched this decision made by France with confusion. Two important questions came to me. If France abolished slavery, why was it reinstated? If France reinstated slavery, why do we refer to Haiti as the only successful slave revolt in the world? Slavery was abolished when the French monarchy was destroyed in 1789. Radicals created their first French constitution after the American ideology of the Declaration of Independence, known as the Déclaration des droits de l'homme et du citoyen de 1789, the Declaration of the Rights of Man and of the Citizen. The first French constitution stated that les hommes naissent demeurent libres et égaux en droit. Les distinctions sociales ne peuvent être fondées que sur l'utilité commune. Men are born and remain free, and equal in rights, social distinction may be based only on common utility. They believed this was meant for every man regardless of color. This was another reason why the French culture was so important to Brown. In 1802, the rise of Napoleon Bonaparte and his council reinstated slavery in all the ex-French colonies due to the need of financial support to finance Napoleon's wars. Although Napoleon had reinstated slavery, the island of Saint-Domingue, now referred as to Haiti, had a taste of freedom, and revolutionaries such as Toussaint Louverture was not going to allow slavery to be reinforced on his people. The Haitian Revolution, which began in 1790, would go on for 13 years, ending in two major decisions, changes for the entire world. First, Haiti became the first Black Republic in 1804, and second, the anxiety of many slaveholding countries began to develop, especially Haiti's neighbor, America. After understanding the brief history of France and Haiti, I was able to understand the threat that both these nations posed on America. Many southern slaveholding Americans viewed the Haitian as a danger to their productivity and their slaves. The Haitian proved to those who were still in bondage, such as William Wells Brown, that through a revolution, change was possible. After studying French colonial history and reading the novel Clotel, I realized that for Brown, France represents freedom. For the remainder of my project, my presentation, I would like to explore the idea. First, by briefly looking at Brown's nonfiction travel narrative, 3 years in Europe, and then by turning to the novel Clotel. By doing this, we can see why Brown would make France the place where both mother and child will be free, and where color was not a crime. Brown argues two important aspects in 3 years in Europe. The first would be the idea that color is not a crime. His acceptance into the French culture after his escape in 1834 was exceptional. Living in Europe as a fugitive slave, Brown is impressed with the French people. The French are not only the first to abolish slavery, but are the first to publish African stories and poetry, giving Brown hope to one day publish his own novel. In 1849, being a member of many anti-slavery societies, Brown is invited to join the Second International Peace Conference held in France. This conference represented everything Brown hoped. It was a gathering of freed men of different nationalities and culture with one main goal, freedom for all. He was able to meet great peacemakers of the world, such as Victor Hugo, and I quote, as Brown's colored face and curly hair did not prevent him from getting an invitation. Brown's welcome to France was an acceptable one. This was also seen through Madame Tocqueville, the wife of the Minister of Foreign Affairs statement. I hope you feel yourself free in Paris. Or Brown's summary on the country where he states, few nations are more courteous than the French. Hear the stranger, let him come from what country he may, and be ever so unacquainted with the people and language, he is sure of a civil reply to any question that he may ask. I was not laughed at once in France. This acceptance of his color and his being later is transmitted into Clotel, where Brown leaves the reader with the sole survivor of his novels in France. The other aspect that is worth taking a look at is Brown's comparison of the French Constitution and the American Constitution. Comparing both these ideologies was essential to Brown. To the author, it was a difference of treatment towards him as a human being. Visiting Paris, Brown states, had I been in America, where color is considered a crime, I would not have been seen at such a gathering unless as a servant. Although both documents represent the freedom of man and the Declaration of Independence was a model for the Déclaration des droits de l'homme et du citoyen, Brown argues the idea of the French being better interpreters than the American of their constitution. In the French Constitution, men are born and remain free and equal in rights, regardless of their color. Thus, in the Declaration of Independence, all men are created equal except blacks. Comparing both constitutions allows me to agree with the idea that Eve Rimona writes in her book, The Tragic Mulatto Revisited. America's identity is both interracial and tragic from its earliest beginnings. Reading Brown's account of his life in Europe helped me to understand the freedom and accessibility that was possible for fugitive slaves. In Clotel, Brown transfers many experiences from his life onto the character Clotel. By analyzing Clotel's thoughts and feelings in the novel, then we understand how Brown's thoughts about freedom and race developed in the 1850s. At this moment, I will give you a summary of the novel, which will later help me explain my findings. Clotel was written in 1853. Clotel is not only the name of the novel, but also one of the main characters. Clotel is the daughter of the former president, Thomas Jefferson. Throughout the novel, we follow the life of Clotel and her sister, who are sold into slavery as sexual objects. Both women almost escape slavery, but are unable to. The episodes in the novel mostly take place in America, but also take place in ex-colonies that belong to France. At the end of the novel, Mary, Clotel's daughter and her husband, end up in France, where they can be free. In the interest of time, I would like to show you just two examples where Francophone culture plays an important role in the novel. The first would be a conversation between two old school friends, Mr. Peck, a Southern slaveholder, and Carlton, a Northerner. As Mr. Peck defends the reasoning of slavery through the Bible, Carlton answers, I regret, I cannot see eye to eye with you. I am a disciple of Rousseau and have for years made the rights of man my study. And I must confess to you that I can see no difference between white men and black men as regards to liberty. Here Brown argues the idea that both men studied in northern states, but one has been transformed by slavery, while the other has remained untouched by slavery. Slavery has influenced Mr. Peck to believe that the Bible supports the idea of inhuman treatment towards black. On the other hand, Carlton, who remained in the north, continued to support the French philosopher's idea that liberty has no color because every man is free and becomes slave due to the injustice of society. My second example would be the ending of the novel. Clotel's daughter, Mary, escapes to France where she rejoins her husband to live free. Here, Brown speaks of the reunion of both fugitive slaves. We can both but blush for our country's shame when we recall to mind the fact that while George and Mary Green and numbers of other fugitive slaves from American slavery can receive protection from any of the governments of Europe, they cannot return to their native land without becoming slaves. What is very interesting about this passage is the fact that Brown chooses France out of all the other countries to end his novel. George Green first arrived in England where, I quote, was ashamed of his African descent, and he never once mentioned the fact of having been a slave. The author again puts his hope into France as being the most appropriate country for fellow fugitive slaves to reside. France provided Mary with a happy ending. She was able to marry George, reside in a precious home, and live freely amongst others. This is This was where fugitive slaves could live and no one would laugh at them, as Brown stated. Continue with the idea from Eve, Ramon, that America is both interracial and tragic, leads the reader to understand the outcome of many characters in the novel. Brown uses Clotel and other female characters in his sentimental novel to represent America as the tragic mulatto. A tragic mulatto would be interpreted as a woman of mixed culture, such as African and American descent in this case, which no matter the path she pursues, her ending will always be tragic due to society. In representing America as a tragic mulatto, Brown warns Americans of the country's rape, the future. Although Clotel is a fictional character, born from a slave and a former president of the United States, Brown makes it clear in examples in the novel that the country has continued to enslave people for centuries, that they have begun to enslave men and women just for profit and by tradition. France's decision to abolish slavery had allowed Americans to view blacks living in community in a civilized and as civilized being. Haiti proved to support itself during the 19th century just like any other Caucasian ruling country, again creating hope and connection with France and the author. In the first African-American novel, Brown urged to demonstrate the hope of pursuing the dream of being free. At the end of the novel, the author demonstrates freedom as his main character, Clotel, jumps off the Long Bridge in Washington, D.C., preferring death over slavery. He leaves his readers with the hope of being free is either through death or is going to France, just like he did in Mary, Clotel's daughter. Clotel's sad but hopeful ending questions America's future of the 19th century. No longer can a woman or her child be safe in their own country. In Brown's novel, Clotel, the only happy ending possible for Black American is one that takes place in France.